My name is Fateh and we are from Beaconhouse Barriott on campus. We have made the periscope as well as the battery-powered drone. So our aim to make this is to teach the people of the world that how a CD circuit works, and our another aim of ours is that we want to show our talents to the world. Our ambition is to contribute to the scientific society as much as we can.
So what is this exactly, and how have you made this?
This is a battery-powered drone, and these four batteries are interconnected into a series circuit. The series circuit makes sure that all four of the motors are provided with the same amount of current. Now, the same amount of current is also going to make sure that the propellers move in a continuous and a swift manner.
Can you show us that?
It works.
Wow, that's very amazing. What about you? What have you made?
I've made a periscope over here. It works because of the mirrors and the reflection of light. First, the light is reflected into mirror 1, then into mirror 2 over here, and then into your eye, and you can see the object over here. This is basically used in submarine and tanks. In submarine, a soldier can see out to the battlefield without coming out of the hatch, and he's safe inside. And a sailor in a submarine can see outside the surface and explore the sea.
That's very nice. Let's move forward and see what the others have done. Assalamu alaikum. Please tell us about your name institution first.
I'm Hameema Humayun. I'm from Liberty Campus, Beacon House.
So what have you made, Hameema?
We've made two projects. Both of them have the same concept with hydraulic pressure. You might have seen them in practical use in car washes, where there's a machine that lifts the car. That's a hydraulic machine. So we made these two projects to simply explain that. Now, all these hydraulic machines work by the same principle. It's called the Pascal principle. It states that if pressure is exerted on one side of an enclosed liquid, it will be equally transmitted throughout the liquid, which basically means that if I apply pressure here on this syringe, it will be transported here and the book will lift. Now this other thing, it's the same thing, just we presented it differently. One of the arms moves like this and the other moves like this. Now, apart from the stark difference, there's another one that over here we were lifting the object. So we needed a bigger syringe here, so there was more area and hence more force. So, yeah.
So what have you used exactly? How have you made these? Is this wood or chart paper?
This is wood. This is a syringe. We fixed it with a coil and we had to like use drills and stuff to make this. And they're just attached in that way. It was a very simple project and we just used it practically.
Thank you so much. That's very nice. Let's move forward to see what the others have done. This is entirely colorful. What is this?
So this is a healthy eating pyramid. Our topic is relationship between health, diet, and exercise. So we measure the person's BMI and tally it with a weight height chart and tell them if they're overweight, underweight, or they're normal, and how to lead to a healthy life. So this is a healthy eating pyramid, and Fatma will explain.
Hello, so in this pyramid we have this section in things you should eat in moderation, and this is things you can have every day, because this is dairy, which you should, which is good for, because it has calcium and it's good for your bones. And this is fruits and vegetables, which you should also have every day. And this is grains, which is really good for, which makes most of your meals.
I am Mohammed Hamza from ITU, and we are representing Makistan, the first academic makerspace by ITU in Arfasa Software Technology Park. This makerspace is not just about robotics, it's about just all kinds of making, music making, designing, and we are presenting some of our projects here.
Can you tell us a little about this one and that one?
Yeah. This is a humanoid robot, a self-balancing robot. Normal robot uses the wheels to perform motions, but the difficult thing about humanoid robot is self-balancing. This robot self-balancing itself using its arm and precise motions. Just a demo here is this one. Just like we use our arms and hands to during walking to perform actions and stabilize ourselves, this uses the same principle. And this is a 3D printed arm. It is designed by a Gale, a designer, French designer, and open source it. It is 3D printed and it is in construction phase. This is just arm. And still we are working on it and printing these parts of the robot.
How does this arm manage to move exactly? Who is ordering it to move?
For now, we have uploaded a random code in it to present a demo. It has a proper controller and it will be an AI bot. Just like we have a chip for this robot, and this one is an AI chip for this one robot. And this is the basic demo of this arm. This arm is moving using these principles, servo motors. And it can perform all actions a human can perform, that is twisting and grabbing things, etc.
My name is Ahmed, and this is basically a project which prints numbers on a whiteboard. So this is a robot which can print those numbers. So you tell me any number from 0 to 9, and then it can
Okay, print me 6.
6. Okay. Now it's going to be starting.
Wow, that's very impressive. That's a 6. Yeah. Very, very impressive. So how did you make this?
Basically, I made the model using Lego. And then I placed the motors. This one is for the right and left movement. And then this one is for the up and down. So by combining them, I can construct all of the numbers.
So what do you think? How far will this invention go?
It can go further. Like I can have double-digit numbers or triple. And I can have letters as well and words. So I'll try doing that.
Any application you have in mind? What's the first place you want this to be implemented in?
It can be implemented in like classrooms for like kindergarten. So like the robot draws in and it asks the kids what number is this or what.
That's very impressive. And I've heard you are really good at jigsaw solving puzzles, right? So give us a demo about how fast you can do this. What's your record? And tell us your name.
My name is Ashton Kaleem. My record for 3x3 Rubik's Cube is 7.66 seconds.
Wow, that's very impressive. I would like to see a demo if that's... Wow, that's very impressive. Is there a secret to this?
There's a method. So in the method, there's like different algorithms that you have to memorize. And there's about like 10 of them that you have to memorize for a beginner's method. But to get fast, you have to memorize like more methods. So like I know algorithms, like I know around 50, 60 algorithms.
I'm Elise Ahmed from grade 9.
I'm Ayman Habib from Learning Alliance.
Grade 9. We're both from Learning Alliance, 01.
Alright, so tell us a little about what you've made.
We made a vacuum cleaner out of recycled materials. So this first recycled material we used was the plastic bottle and then this pipe, and then we have a motor, a filter and a fan inside it, which is made by a recycled deodorant. So basically how it works is that when we turn it on, the motor turns on and then it sucks the dirt. We use this thermopole sheet as an example of dirt. And the basic principle of this is that jitni zyada capacity hogi of the motor and the batteries, the more the suction, the more the capacity, the more the suction. Yeah.
And where do you see your project in the next 10 years?
I don't think it's ready to go into the market yet. It's just a prototype.
No, but the thing is that it's recycling, right? And you know how important recycling is in the world.
I think instead of wasting waste material, we should use stuff to make such interesting things, which could be very helpful for the daily lifestyle of different individuals.
My name is Maniha Kamran. I'm from the Trust School, Amitown branch. And I'm in grade 10th. So I'm here to explain the fractional distillation of crude oil. Crude oil is extracted from the earth and it is formed by the decomposition of many organic matters. It is refined in the industries. In the refining process, we got about 6 different fractions of crude oil, and there's a residue left behind. And after this fraction distillation, we get about 23 different oils, and these oils have many vast applications in our life. So the major use of this oil is that it is our petrol. We use in our cars and many other. They are used in the industries for the chemical industries and many other applications in our life. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Let's see what the rest of there are a lot of more projects here. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam. I'm Zainab Zahid from the Trust School, Amitown Senior Girls Campus. I'm here to describe the sexual reproduction in flowering plants. Flowers are actually of 3 types, mosses, ferns and flowering plants. But the sexual reproduction occurs only in flowering plants. Because flower is the part of the male reproductive part and female reproductive part. The outermost part of the sepal is the green color. The function of the other parts is to protect them. Next part is the petals. वो कलरफुल होता है वो कलरफुल इसलिए होता है ताकि बीज ह्यूमंस सब उसे अट्रैक्ट हो जो कि एक्चुअली पोलिनेशन एजेंट्स हैं उसके बाद जो थर्ड पार्ट है वो स्टेमन है जो मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट है उसके ऊपर एक एंथर होता है जिसमें पोलन ग्रेन्स फॉर्म होते हैं और पोलन ग्रेन्स ही आगे फर्टिलाइजेशन के लिए जरूरी होते हैं अगर वो नहीं होंगे तो कुछ भी नहीं होगा द लास्ट पार्ट इज कार्पल व्हिच इज द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट उसकी बेस ओवरी होती है और उसका मिड स्टाइलेटर और ऊपर स्टिग्मा होता है स्टिग्मा बहुत स्टिकी होता है स्टिकी इसलिए होता है ताकि जब पोलन ग्रेन्स गिरें तो वो उसी के ऊपर गिरें कहीं और डिस्पर्स ना हो ये हमारे फ्लावर का स्ट्रक्चर है हम फ्लावर देखते हैं लेकिन उसके स्ट्रक्चर को मॉडिफाई करके नहीं देखते उसके बारे में नहीं पता होता तो हमारा मकसद ये था कि हम आपको बताएं कि फ्लावर के अंदर भी बहुत सारे स्ट्रक्चर हैं
My name is Afshal Jamil and I am from the Trust School and a student of class 5. Today my model is related with the production and utilization of solar energy. Basically, solar energy is a simple energy provided by the sun. This energy is the form of solar radiation which makes the production of solar electricity possible. Solar electricity can be produced directly from photovoltaic. Photovoltaic literally means electric and light. We can use solar energy in numbers of ways, like as heat for hot water, heating buildings and for cooking. It is also used by the plant for the process of photosynthesis. We can also use sun rays for drying our clothes, etc. In this model, the sun is providing the energy and it is connecting with the power station. And in the power station, it is turning into electricity. And with the help of these electric towers, electricity is being supplied in the domestic areas, in the desired areas. And the solar panels are also doing this work. The lights are glowing on the road with the help of the solar panels and vehicles are also running.
My name is Plan Mahmood. I am the student of class 5 from the school. My model is about smoke because a current problem is smog. Today I am going to tell you how smog is produced, what are the effects and what are the solutions. How smog is produced? When factories pollution, construction pollution and vehicles pollution mix, they make smog. And when smog and sunlight mix, they make ground level ozone. Dangerous mixture of air pollutants including gases and particles that can often be seen as brownish yellow haze consists of ground level ozone, particulate matter, nitrogen oxide, sulfur dioxide and volatile organic compounds which you can...
How harmful is this? How harmful is smoke?
Its effects are eyes, nose, and throat irritation, reduce lung capacity and tightness in the chest. It may also worsen condition of people with asthma, chronic bronchitis, and heart problems. Iske solutions kya hai? Hum logo ko extensive plantation karni chahiye kyunki plants give us oxygen. City areas affected should be far away. Industrial smoke should be treated and make ineffective before it is in the atmosphere. We should reduce the use of volatile organic compounds. We should reduce burning.
We are made a parking plaza. जैसे आपको parking plazas round shape में होते हैं, आपको जाके cars park करनी पड़ती हैं, या आपको मतलब यूं roads के side पे parking plazas build कर दिए जाएं और उन पे आप अपनी road कहीं भी आप अपनी car को park कर सकते हैं, जिसकी वजह से हम hydraulic press के through आपकी car को attach करेंगे, उसके बाद हम आपकी car को lift कर लेंगे.
The law from a Blaise Pascal scientist in the 17th century, he gave this idea and it is applicable in many fields nowadays. Like in our cranes, you can see that I require a very little force to move this heavy frame. It has too much application that you require a little force and you got a very big output from these things.
That's very nice.
This one is a bladeless fan. You can see there is no wing right there and you are filling air. It's specially made for the children that you don't have a fear of any kind of damage, electric shock or any other thing. This basically, there is a motor right there. It sucks air from these holes and then it circulates through this frame. You can also change the temperature of the air by placing any hot or cold ring right there. It's a very secure thing for the children.